Suffenus iste vare, quem probe nosti, homo est venustus, et dicax, et urbanus. Idemque longe plurimos facit versus. Puto esse illi, milia, decem, plura perscripta. Nec sic ut fit in palimpsesto relata. Cartae regiae, novi libri, novi umbilici, lora rubra, membranae, directa plumbo et pumic omnia equata. Haec cum legas tu bellus illet urbanus Suffenus, unus caprimulgus aut fossor ursus videtur. Tanto abhorret ac mutat. Hoc quid putemus esse? Cui modo scurra, aut si quid hac rescitius videbatur, id in facetu est in faceti orure, simil poema tatigit, nec quid unquaeques beatus ac poema conscribit. Tam gaudat in se, tamqua se ipse miratur. Nimir uido omnes falimur, nec est quisquam quem non in aliquare videre Suffenum possis. Suus cuique attributus est error, sed non videmus manticae quod intergo.
That Suffenus, Varus, whom you know quite well, is an elegant, witty, and refined fellow. But at the same time, he writes far too many verses. I think 10,000 or even more have been written by him, not presented as usual on recycled parchment, but regal sheets, brand new paper, new scroll rods, red leather straps, fine parchment wrappers, all ruled with lead and ends polished with pumice. But when you read them, that charming and urbane Suffenus seems instead only a goat milker or ditch digger, so different is he, so much has he changed. What should we think of this? He who just now seemed an elegant wit, or if there is anything cleverer than that, the very same person is cruder than the rough countryside as soon as he touches poetry. Nor is he ever as happy as when he's writing a poem. So pleased is he with himself, so much does he admire himself. Likewise, all of us, no doubt, are deceived. Nor is there anyone whom in some respect you cannot see Suffenus. To each has been allotted his own delusion. But we do not see the bag that is on our back.